already. We have 9 students. You know, we have 5 groups, 2 consisting of 2 students per group each. But there is one student who is just working alone. So we have total 5 groups in total. And you've got 1 week to complete a circuit. You've got 1 week to complete a circuit and present as to how you will achieve this, technically mentioning the code, techniques, algorithms, and demonstrations. So basically, you have to display how you are working. You need to maybe present your work in coding, what technique you have used, what algorithm you have used in coding. That's all you have to present. Bonus marks will be given to the group who will finish the work at earliest. So there will be special bonus marks for a student who will finish this work earlier. Or if you add some more better functionality, it is not written here, but if you add more better functionality in the circuit, that can even let you earn more bonus points in your exams. Okay, how you will be evaluated? The assessment part, how you will be evaluated. At the end of this project, you will have to give a group presentation and viva. So everyone out of, you know, if you are 2 in the group, you 2 will present the overall project, and then you will be asked questions. You have to submit individual reports. So the report that you will submit will not be one per group. It will be, if you are 2 students in one group, each one of you will submit his own individual report, what you have done in the project, what is your contribution in the project. So the project, this group presentation will be one for the whole group, but the report submitted will be separate for each student, and that will mention what that particular student has done, what you have done, what is your contribution in the project. Okay, and then possibly there might be a quiz. It can be, it cannot be, but you can expect a quiz, because so that, you know, to make sure that you know the concepts of 7 segments, you know the concepts of push buttons, and you know the